Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to our furniture flipping adventure. My name is Sarah, and as you can see, I have two pieces here. I'm going to be putting them head to head in this versus challenge. One, I'm going to be painting a neutral, and the other, I'm going to be painting a color. So I'm going to start with the neutral today. Now, I fell in love with these as soon as I saw them, and I knew I had to have at least one of them, but as I was at an auction, I ended up winning both of them. I couldn't be happier to be able to kind of put to the test which we like better, neutral or color, and which one will sell faster in my area. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna start this piece by taking these doors off so I can get in and clean more easily. Also, I'm gonna be doing something with the wicker. I haven't decided completely yet, but it's gonna be easier if the doors are off for that anyway. After I move the hardwares and all the screws, I'm gonna wanna put them together and in a safe place so I don't lose them. Because if you've ever seen my shop, I'm not the most organized person in the world. Sorry. But I love these handles and I'm definitely gonna be reusing them. Not only is cleaning important for the preparation of your piece, but it's also a great time where you're going to actually be touching every part of the surface, finding any areas that might need filled or any damage that might need fixed before you go ahead and start painting. So it kind of has twofold benefits. You're getting it cleaned and you're making sure there's nothing wrong with it that might come up partway through the piece. Like I said earlier, I decided that I'm going to do this first piece in a neutral color. So let's talk about what I would consider to be neutral colors. I would say definitely white and black, and then since in between is kind of gray, I consider gray a neutral color as well. And probably like beiges, I would call those pretty neutral. Am I missing any? If I'm missing something that you would consider a neutral, go ahead and leave it down in the comments. Educate me. I don't know. I feel like those are the main four: white, black, grays, and tans. Those are kind of what I would consider neutrals. So surprise, surprise, I'm gonna go with black. I have black on hand, and I also just really like the look of black furniture. I think it's gonna go well with what I'm gonna be doing with the wicker, and I'm excited to get the color on. I feel like sometimes there's so much different kind of prep work going into getting to the painting part that it seems like we do more prep than we do painting. And that's just the way these projects go. But I'm excited to start painting, so let's get going. As you can see, I've already finished off the wicker just the way I wanted it. And I'll show you that in our part two video, just so you're not watching the same video twice. When I use my paint sprayer, I usually add a little bit of water to my chalk paint. It's a pretty thick paint, so adding water will help it spray more easily. And I have to say that this is the most awkward piece I have ever worked on. I've never done a bookshelf before, and with these fixed shelves not being able to come out, it is a nightmare getting into the corners, especially of that top cubby. Because of the size of my paint sprayer itself, I was running into things that I'd already painted with the top of my hopper, and it wasn't easy, let me just say that. And this is the moment I ran out of paint and had to go get a fresh can of classic Noir. And then I dropped the lid.
Well, that went well.
I had a couple of spots of bleed through after this first coat of paint, so I'm gonna throw some shellac over it. I did two coats before continuing with my second coat of black paint over top. So I made a little bit of a mistake this morning. My husband was busy, so I thought I'd just throw this thing on the dolly, get it out of the garage, no big deal. But we have a lip from the garage to the concrete here, and one wheel went down before the other, and it rocked, and since it toppled, and I caught it with one hand, hurt my hand, tried to keep it from falling. It put a couple gashes over here, some scratches here, hurt the foot over here. It wasn't lovely. So I've sanded down these gashes and moving forward. But be careful moving things that are bigger than you, even if you have a dolly.
And here is a super exciting clip of me painting black over black. Enjoy. It's top coat time, which means we're almost done. For the main part of the bookshelf, I added a little bit of black paint to my hopper and mixed it in with my top coat before spraying, but over the wicker piece, I sprayed just straight poly, because if I had used the tinted stuff, which I almost did, I'd have been so mad at myself and it would have ruined things. But luckily, I remembered to switch.
All right, so that's the end of our neutral side of our challenge. Let me know if you would have chosen black or maybe a different color to be the entry for the neutral side. And especially let me know what you think of a color. Be specific as you can, a particular shade, and let me know what color you would paint the other one. Who knows, I might pick it. but I'm excited to get some color on the other piece. I already have it primed and waiting, so let's see what we can do with it and put them head to head. I'll be listing them for the same price and at the same time so that they have an equal opportunity to be sold, and we'll see which one sells fastest in this area. I can't wait to see you all next week. If you're not subscribed, make sure you are so you don't miss out on our part 2 of this video. Until then, I'm Sarah with our Furniture Flipping Adventure. Bye for now.